Alright.
And we're streaming. Woohoo! You're famous now. Anyways.
Well, doesn't she still have to pick a channel?
Yeah. Let's see. No IP. Yes, I want to continue. I don't really want to use that. Oh, why?
But why?
Because you don't have enough of the game.
So. Uh-oh.
That's okay. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to do a bot game. We're going to do a beginner bot game. We're going to do me and you. And we're going to... We're going to ask very nicely for them to give us bot and support.
Alright. Please and thank you.
Praise
to be gentle.
They never are, though.
They very rarely are, yes. It's like, I'm sorry. There's no babies in this game.
No babies. Oh,
darn.
How do you decline a bot game? Just do the honorable thing in AFK.
Seriously.
What's
and hello, and ladies and gentlemen. This is Trouble again. I'm being shown how to play League of Legends because I am nowhere near as awesome as Crumble is at Smite. It's just mainly pretty much the thing I would do in Smite is I would probably just follow her around so that way you could see how awesome she is, and then I would just bait people so that way they attack me instead of her as the easy kill. But anyways, this is my new friend, Nurse Mimi. She will be showing me the ropes. And hopefully I will not embarrass her too much.
That's okay. I embarrass myself plenty.
Woo! Wait, what?
So I don't have a support page. Okay, so here's what you're gonna do. What champions do you see on your champion list right now?
Ashe, Garen, Jinx, Kha'Zix, Lissandra, Lux, Ryze, Shyvana, Varus, and Wukong.
Okay. I'm gonna have you go with Ashe.
Okay. Oh, so an archer.
Super basic. It's a good place to start. You're gonna want to definitely walk in.
On one arrow.
What spells do you have available?
Again.
Okay. Ow!
All the skins. Like, you could look awesome, but you don't. Sorry.
Yeah, I feel that way a lot. I have skins for some of them.
What?
The skins.
Oh. Yeah, that's how they get you. Really is. Like, that
it's like
is
the only thing you pay into for League.
So, I mean, I know in Smite, like, if you pay, you know, up front, then you could get all access to all gods, whether they're currently in or they're coming out. In League, is it, like,
Well, for League, what you do is, the actual money that you can spend in-game is going to be skins, boosts, and, like, really practical shit.
Okay.
So, if you need to change your summoner name, you can use real people money on that. If you need to buy a champion, you earn influence points during your games, and because this is a different kind of bot game than what we were originally going to play, you'll see that IP go up at the end.
Mm-hmm.
And you can use that toward your purchase of different champions and a few other different things, like runes and mastery pages, things like that, that are more necessary to the game itself.
Okay.
You can pretty much play entirely free League and still be one of the best people playing it.
Hmm. Okay.
But if you put that much time into it, chances are that you've bought some shit.
Yeah, at the end of the day, you still end up buying something, though. Like, I have skins.
So pretty much all, like, real world money can only really be spent on looking more pretty, but everything in-game is, like, in-game money?
Well, you can still buy the champion. Anything you can buy with IP, which is influence points, you can buy with RP as well, which is Riot points, being real money translated into a point system.
Okay, alright.
but there are some things that you can only buy with RP, and that's the cosmetic stuff.
Okay.
And the boosts. Like, I have an IP boost right now because I love to pay into getting more out of it.
Makes sense.
And I'll, like, for a while I had something close to almost 9,000 in influence points. So I could buy any champion I wanted.
All the champions.
I guess I need Lindsay for the starting. For you going bot, why don't you take... What does it say in your recommended? You're going to mouse over the little guy.
The little guy. Home start? No.
Welcome.
Here's the little guy.
The little guy, right up, based on your orientation, slightly left and upward. Right next to the Jinx, the blue haired chick that just left.
Is Jinx playing mid?
No, that's the person I buy stuff from. We must press that's on. A moose.
Right
or
here.
Something.
Right here.
Oh, okay. And
it's a moose.
It's the first animal that comes to my mind. Moose?
Oh, shit, dude.
Starting items, Doran's Blade, Hell Potion, and Warding Totem.
Okay, so get the Warding Totem. Kay. For sure, because it's free.
And then Boots of Speed.
Get the Doran's Blade, and then a few health pots.
Okay. And I can get one health pot. Yay!
What the hell happened? So this Jinx is going down bot, and I am not going to support that bitch.
Your character is so adorable. I love its hat. I want to wear it.
You should hear some of her flavor text. That tasted purple.
I like her already. Anybody that says they taste purple is awesome in my book.
Alright, so as the main DPS, what you want to do is work on last hitting these minions. So when it gets low, like how this guy is right here, hit him. Yeah. I'm going to take so many hits for you.
Truly appreciated.
If you wanted to take hits, you should have gone with something more tanky.
I imagine we want to work on the minions
snared.
Before...
Snared! Alright, we're playing against an Ash as well. So you'll want to pay some attention to how she does the things.
Back up.
You need to back up a little bit.
Okay.
Anytime that you see that field there with Lux especially, just don't.
Okay, I was wondering, I was like, what is that?
It's not a good thing. Not a good time.
It slows you if you're in it and damages you if you're in it in the field.
Ow. Okay.
Run away! Oh god! Alright.
I haven't seen her really using her ability.
So, which ability did you get first?
QWER.
If you have your Q, start using it to poke our enemies. Like, they get close, right? And you go up and you're like, motherfucker, Glitter Lance! I mean, you're not Glitterlands, that's me, but...
Yeah,
see, there we go.
Okay. Sorry, Is there a way to, like, change it so that the camera moves along with you? That's...
Yes, you hit Y.
Y, okay. That was one thing that was kind of throwing me off, because it's like, that's kind of automatic in Heroes. I'm just like, ooh, I'm not used to the whole not...
Oh, yeah, it's so obnoxious. did you set your spells to autocast?
No.
Or do you have to double-click for every spell?
I didn't change anything, so probably whatever the default is.
I think when you hit escape, you're going to want to go and hit quick cast all, and that way your spells will be cast in the direction of your mouse and not okay. based on moment to moment where you have to click and point, click and point, click and point. It wastes a lot of time.
Ah, the lovely fight of minions.
We really should be pushing back harder than this.
Yeah.
And the good thing is that I'm
mostly
a high damage type of support. So I can make up for anything that you're kind of missing right now.
That was a good push.
Wow, the minions come in pretty damn fast.
The minion waves?
Yeah.
Oh, it's... yeah, as soon as one spawns, like, and gets close, the next one's on its way.
Dang.
So when I say last hitting, you're getting the little, like, money amount for each one, right?
Yeah.
It's important to do timing. So because I'm the support, I'm going to make a point to do this. You don't really have to do it quite so much, but it's something to remember. Warding is super important in real people games. You want to have map awareness, you want to know, because we're not playing a typically structured game.
Mm-hmm.
Usually when you're playing with real people, they'll be doing top, mid, bottom, and support, and then a jungler.
And then, so you want to have the wards so you don't get ganked.
Yeah, that. Alright, so what are you feeding into for your build right now? Do you know?
Let's see. No, I actually haven't even gotten my third thing yet.
What you should be doing... Okay, and when it has this little blue... This green outline right here... Blue, I'm retarded.
That's the tower range.
Don't get hit by that, especially not this early game. You might power dive later on with some champions that are heavier hitters, but as things are right now, just don't. Ah, yeah! Miss it! Miss it, bitch! Yeah! Get it! There we go. Yay. That's what we want.
I should have gotten a little bit close for that.
Alright, so when we do back, which eventually you will, what you're going to buy is going to be mainly that stuff like that Doran's Blade. When it says it's going to give you attack damage, get it. For Ash specifically, which unfortunately none of the champions that you have available are ones that I've done a lot of time with. So
that out always is.
So you're gonna want to build like attack speed and damage.
Okay.
Which there's a way to structure the page. Where where you figure out, like...
Watch out!
Oh, God, no! Oh, Lux, no, why?
Why? The huge mentities.
Oh, yeah, you want to get boots, too.
Oh, I was about to say, it's like, I saw boots of speed, so I was like...
You
want to get those
you're
at some
build
point.
Those into, For now, just kind of go with what's recommended.
Okay.
For you, probably Berserker's Greaves. For me, it's not going to be quite the same as that.
Ooh, a little outnumbered. Help minions. Thank you.
Now I'm coming back down there. When I get back down there, I'm going to have you go back.
Get some Menarmanar.
Yeah. Because otherwise our bots are going to outplay us. Why don't you can tab and see what the other Ash is building, and maybe build based on something like that.
Okay.
Because you'll be able to tab and mouse over, and it'll tell you exactly what she is buying.
Hi there. Getting a little,
But she's used to now,
wow.
Ash, so don't.
Alright. Is there any sort of hotkey to, like, teleport back, or is it all run?
B.
B?
B.
Okay. Yay, recall! That's the word I was looking for.
That's the one! Oh, again, like, super heavy support. I pretty much just chased that Ash down and almost killed her. Not that I meant to. Like, I was saving her for you, I'm sure. But...
Well, that's the support.
Where's the other Ash? BF Sword and Doran's Blade.
Support.
Is it?
Yeah.
What is it?
The Frost Queen's Claim or some nonsense.
So I can either get the BF Sword or more Doran's Blade.
Oh, God, BF Sword. Okay. Doran's Blade. Eventually you have to sell the Doran's Blade.
Okay, alright.
So it's not a good investment once you learn some better builds for the champions you use. It's a good advance investment early game because it gives you such a burst. United, we are stronger. But once you start playing a little bit more seriously, you don't end up bothering with that. Like, I usually, on a lot of my champions, I use a boots build.
Swiftly now. Lovely boots.
Where you start with boots and health pots and sort of work your way up from there. See, really, I should be hanging back here with you. I should not be thinking.
But you're like, it's a boss game, it's alright. And you're like, wait, nope, nope, nope.
Well, no, okay, so the champion that I'm playing is actually meta for top and mid right now. She's really not usually a support, but she's the closest thing to support that I have. So you should be, at this point, with your mana, keep track of it, but you should be using your abilities pretty liberally.
Okay.
Oh, run away!
Ooh, too much, too much. Hey guys, thanks for the supports.
If you realize that your mana is dwindling, there's a way on the summoner store to sort of focus what you need from your items.
Okay.
And you'll just hit like mana and AD, and it'll pop up with some items that you can use.
Skills, do they work on the towers?
Not so much, no.
Okay, alright. No, I wanted to make sure, because yeah, it's the same in Smite. Where it's just like, nah, there's don't even
gonna be,
bother.
There's going to be a lot of similarities to Smite.
Yeah.
Not so much the scoring, but...
I'm trying to get me some ash.
Oh, I got a turret! Yeah. Have I not like okay? I just assumed that you knew, but have I not explained to you what the whole purpose of the game itself is?
I mean, I imagine it's about the same as all MOBAs, which is get to the end and then take down their thing. I mean, go through the turrets. Ow.
Kill some things.
Yeah, kill all the things.
Yeah. Unstoppable.
My aim is steady. Yeah, my Crumble is actually kind of not happy with Smite right now. They made some like pretty big changes and she's like, yeah, it's kind of ruined a lot of the experience, so oh dang.
I still haven't played it. I went to check it out. On the PS4 network earlier, and it was like $30? What?
No, the game itself should be free. It's this thing where, you know, like here, you know, they have the free rotation, and if you want... Oh, you biznatch. To unlock, like I said, all the gods and all the... pretty much all the recent gods, or current gods, rather, and any gods that will be coming out later... is what the $30 is.
Okay.
Yeah. So
it's not a terrible deal.
It's really not. It's really not. So I mean,
I'm like, I have not been able to find how to download it for PS4 or PC without paying money for it. I'm not sure what I'm doing wrong.
That is odd. Oh, we're almost down with this one. Come on, guys. We can do
I'm just assuming it's user error at this point.
Oh, it might be.
Close.
We still have some.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Yeah. I'm just like, oh, there's minions. No.
No, they're not going to kill you, probably.
There's enough of them. Oh, I totally aimed that kind of funky. Oh, well then.
Don't let her do it.
Yeah.
She'll try.
It's one of those things where it's like, I'm not sure if, like, how line of sight.
Oh god!
You know how dependent. Oh, jeez! Wow, they are just really going after my lovely booty.
They want you. They want
they
you
do.
Bad.
I can't blame them, but you know, I can't blame them. What am I talking about?
You can blame them for
what? Come on! Yes!
Yeah! See, and that's why we talk about getting that ash.
Right. I gotta get me some ash action.
Very important.
It is very, very important.
When I get back in lane with you, I'm gonna have you be. How much monies do you have right now?
2,450.
Yeah, that's way more
something.
Than yeah. Just yeah. You're gonna go back and buy some shit.
Yay! Spend that money, get some boots, all that stuff. Oh, now we can advance more. Woohoo!
We wanna push forward. And again, because it's a bot game, we're not going to worry as much about it because there's not as much of a roaming issue. But we will want to start placing wards in strategic locations. For example, I'm coming up here. You'll see me now. I'm going to place a ward right here so that our butt is covered if as we advance further.
Okay. I'm going to be. Let it be. So yeah, I mean, for the most part, it is feeling very Heroes of the Stormish. It's just, you know, different characters and everything, so. Let's see. So now I can get Greaves or Infinity Edge or...
Oh, Infinity Edge!
Infinity and beyond.
Usually when you build, you want to build your first major item and then finish your boots.
Okay.
Which, I mean, is still going to be champion-based. Mobifier is a really good site for champion builds. But I would want you to get more familiar with a few different ones and ones that you think you might want to buy before bothering to meander through a champion build.
Man, whoever's up top is kicking ass.
Well, you know, that's a jinx. That's why. Because jinx is super high DPS. Really explosive. And,
You moved.
I've heard Jinx a few times. I really like her. Oh, yeah, thanks. We didn't really need you to do that, dude.
Must be someone that's always...
Well, okay, the champion that he's playing is going to be typical for ganks. He's usually a jungling champion.
Okay.
But he's playing him... What is he playing, mid instead? Like, normally we wouldn't stay in lane quite this long.
Yeah.
We'd be getting some movement going. Going in... Especially you as the ADC. Which is the attack damage carry.
Okay.
You would be going and helping out different lanes that really needed it. I would probably visit mid a few times for the sake of seeing what they needed, trying to be helpful there. Again, I'm not typically a support though, so it's hard for me to tell you, like, oh yeah, this is what supports normally do.
Understood.
Oh yeah,
oh, shit.
Don't be in that.
Sorry.
Don't even touch it. Wait it out.
Right. Patience.
It's hard. It's a difficult thing to cultivate, but... An ally has
been slain. I know, you get a little bloodthirsty and you're like, no, I must have it. And it's like, really work out.
That's when you end up chasing people under the tower and you get your butthole actually handed to you.
Yeah, that's just never a good thing.
Alright, then back up. Yeah. There we go. Yeah, no damage.
Yay.
And then, one of the best strategies for me, with almost any champion, is keep your minions between you and your opponent for as long as possible.
Now, are there, like, camps where, like, you know, there's extra...
Yes, but those are mainly for the junglers.
Okay.
You will get... There's certain camps that you'll get buffs off of.
Ow. Ooh, lady. Ooh.
Your jungler needs those before you do.
Yeah.
But as you get late game, like when you start getting this level where we are right now, 10 and 11, and then past that, if you're the ADC, you might go and, you know, communicate with your jungler, but you might take the red buff because it's more of a, like, health-related buff, and it'll help you be a more effective ADC. But if you're, say, if you're mid and you're playing primarily AP, which is ability power, which is what my character is building right now, you'll want to, again, communicate with the jungler, but see if you have the opportunity to take their blue buff instead.
Okay.
But for the most part, like, because the jungler isn't in lane, they're not getting those minion kills.
Haha, you missed. Oh, no more. No more minions.
No more minions. Like I said, because they're not getting those minion kills, they need something. And their jungle camps are the something that they need. Oh, get away from me, Lux. Nick.
I know you want a piece of this ash, but come on now.
Nah. SpongeBob laugh, though. Oh, sorry, whoops. In the future, though, don't be that ADC that gets super mad at your support for accidentally grabbing a couple of your last hits.
Oh, no. Yeah, for me, it's so like, I understand many... that, like, you know, it's like, KD is not everything. It's like, it's great if you get the top KD, but, like, for the most part, it's a team game. You need to play what the team needs, and, you know, it's gonna happen. There's things you're gonna mix up with people, and it's just kinda like, I don't care, as long as the thing is dead, that's what I care about.
Right. So, we're gonna go here, by the way.
Nope.
You and me, we're just gonna go up, see who else needs help, because we've pushed that turret so far that, see, these are one of the... This is a jungle camp right here.
Okay.
We've pushed this turret so far that we want to sort of do something else, around where we need to be. Start maybe focusing down some of those champions with our teamwork that would be harder for the other team to get, or for the rest of our team to get. As you can see, like, Lux is out of lane now, too.
Yeah.
But as soon as we kind of push this back, we're going to want to go back down to our lane and clean that minion lane up. Now see how he has the red and blue circles going around him?
Mm-hmm.
That's the buff.
Oh, okay.
That's both red and blue buff right there.
Gotcha.
Alright, now we gotta go help him. Let's get that Lux. We can. Ah, Lux. Alright, don't go in there. Alright, looks like we're kinda heading for a team fight right now.
Okay.
Let's all kind of focus up here. Let's get that ash. Sorry about it. Whoops. Not a support. Run away.
Oh no.
I was trying to Lindsay him, it's and my cool. Lindsay was not up.
He wanted some ash, so.
He wanted it so bad.
He was chasing that tail of something fierce.
What's your KDA right now?
Where am I?
It's gonna be up in the top right. It's gonna be 27 versus 11, and then your personal kill death assist.
2-1-1.
Yeah, no, you're good. You're pretty well balanced then. I want so bad to not build how I'm supposed to build as a support, but I'm not gonna do that because I care.
Should I be looking to buy anything else right now, or...?
If you can afford to buy any of the next things on your essential list, go for it. If you can upgrade your boots, do that.
Well, let's see. I have offensive items that are viable. There's the rapid fire cannon and Runon's hurricane. There's upgrading to. I'm assuming that's upgrading Berserker's Greaves.
Yeah, that'll be important. Because you don't want to get caught, like at the end of a fight, just being slower than the enemy champion.
Whoa! Look at me go. All right, am I heading to top? Because it looks like it's a little crowded, or...
You probably could.
They're chasing
I'm
them off.
I'm cleaning up bottom right now.
Okay.
Because they pushed all the way to our turret.
How dare
but
they?
But I don't really need a lot of help with that. I pretty much can handle it.
It looks like they have it handled up top again.
So then if you would like... It looks like our Callista is actually jungling. If you want to mouse over... Like, if you hold your mouse and click on the minimap where she is...
Oops.
You can kind of see some of what's going on with that jungler.
Stand together.
She's currently getting blue buff. But from the enemy camp.
Right.
Do you see what I'm talking about?
I think so. Oh, it's because it's kind of overlapping. I was like, I can't. Oh god, what's that thing?
Yeah, you won't see where you are during that time period, because you're literally just going to click and hold on the minimap and mouse over where it is.
Okay, alright. It's kind of interesting, nice little auto run. That's a big frog thing.
Oh, do you want to get the frog? I'll help you get the frog.
I was just like, this big froggy thingy.
Oh, no! Okay, so she has vision on us. Are you getting the frog or not? Okay, so
I just didn't know what that was. I was like, what is that thing?
If you run too far away from the jungle camp,
it'll
like,
reset
a little bit. But if you run too far away, it starts going back to its original place and auto-healing immediately.
Okay.
Like, you'll just have wasted your time.
That's no bueno.
I'm just gonna take this tower. Nom 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 nom.
Nom 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 towers.
So how are you feeling about it so far? Is this... I feel like there's gonna be a lot of similarities for you, just based on other strategy games that you've played in the past.
Yeah, I mean, for the most part, it's, you know... not too different. It's, you know, again, probably just mainly getting used to the different things and then learning, you know, what builds, what works better, what's more shiny.
Well, and that's the other thing. Once you kind of find a champion rotation you like, it's going to end up being more what you want to do
guy.
And less what you're supposed to be doing.
Nah.
Like, I have a few champions that I know what their recommended builds are. I know what their... builds are on the main guide site, and then I know which builds I like best for them.
Yeah. Oh jeez. Oh no. I'm sorry. I didn't make you angry, Tower. I'm sorry.
Did you get Tower hit?
A little bit.
Look, help me out here.
Nope. Oh, she went around the other way, didn't she?
Yeah, she didn't. Cause we can't go in here.
Yeah.
That's not for us. Oh god, why?
Well, it is and it isn't. Just not right now. It's a little busy.
Oh, we should probably go push with them.
Alright. Sounds good.
Right up. I do love that, like, quick communication factor of League. Just ping where you want to be and where you want to go. So convenient.
Agreed.
Now, a lot of what people... Oh. Games now is just for the sake of trying new champions, so they're not really, or like trying new builds on champions they know. They're gonna be pushing hard, moving fast. There's not as much opportunity for damage as I would like to see.
They're like, no, this is our house. Goodbye now.
That didn't feel good. Perhaps I need to get protective items.
Maybe.
Perhaps.
Perhaps, perchance.
I don't know if you can hear it in the background, but my boyfriend's playing on the wonderful new electric guitar I bought him for a birthday.
Very nice. Oh, my friend, or Maintain is watching. Yes, Jeff, I am trying out League. Nurse Mimi is helping me to see if I can, manage it. Jeff slash Maintain.
A lot of it is just, like, practicing through and getting that initial engage, the initial moment of, what am I doing, out of your head.
Yeah. Okay, so I've upgraded boots. Do I want to get any of these offensive items as of
yet? Anything you can afford. Get any offensive item you can afford. Especially if it says attack damage and attack speed, those are the ones you want.
Alright.
Which, when you mouse over, it should show you the basics of the item.
Yeah. It's like, the one that gives you 30% or 40%? Let me think.
Perhaps 30.
Perhaps.
The other thing, too, is you should be... Usually you'd be building your items. We're going back so infrequently that you end up buying whole items at a time.
Ah, okay.
But usually you'd have sort of a strategy for when you back and when you don't. And what you buy on your next back.
Yeah.
Looks like we're gonna get there. Usually I like us to focus one turret, not both of them.
But yeah. That's what I figured. It's like, well, the minions look like they have this one fairly well, so,
So now I'm in that phase where, like, I had my ultimate on, and all I wanted was another kill. So another one of those aspects of League that is pretty cool, but not a lot of people end up using, is like honoring your teammates. It has a little thumbs up next to the icons.
Oh, okay, yeah, no, they have something similar in Heroes of the Storm. I don't think they have it in Smite as of yet. I mean, they could say, you know, good game or something like that, but yeah, not.
Looks like everybody in our team has sort of left the group there. So, how are you feeling with Ashe?
I mean, yeah, it feels very kind of just standard. Like, if I were to compare it to Heroes of the Storm, kind of similar to playing either, like, Vala or Sylvanas to a point. Sylvanas, his arrows have a little bit more kind of supporty role to them, but... no, it's fairly familiar, I think.
Okay, so then here's what we want to do. Do you remember who your other champions were?
I remember Sun Wukong because he's just a familiar person.
So under your little summoner stats at the top right corner of the game section, you're going to go to the little face thing that says profile. And then when you hit profile, you're going to find champions. Honestly, if I could see you doing this, it would be better.
I know, it's weird, like, it considers PvPNet and the actual, like, game two different things, so... I wonder if I can actually put two of these on at the same time. Let me see if I can do that, because that might work out a whole lot better in a way.
Yeah.
There. Okay. Let me just move this down. Order, move to bottom. Should be fine. So I think these only show up when I actually have it live. Okay. So yeah, that'll work. Okay. So if you go to the stream, you can see where I'm at. I'm looking at, like, I guess the after battle view, overview grid graph thing.
I have to find the thing now.
Twitch.tv/askfortrouble.
It maybe was in my history.
Yay.
Alright, so we're going to look at that. This is not where you want to be.
Okay. Home?
Go to your home.
Okay.
I have to watch through this stupid ad. This is the most ridiculous ad ever.
I bet. I mean, it's one of those things where they're, you know, you can pay so that way, you know, people don't get ads and, you know, it keeps your streams for like, because usually I think they only keep them around for like a week or two at the most. But if you go, you know, they call it going turbo, they'll keep your replays around for like 60 days. But I'm just kind of like, but I have YouTube for that. So that's why I just push my stuff over to to YouTube. And it's just so much easier.
Yeah, that follows. All right. So okay. where you have your little thing, it says play, and you go to your right, has asked for trouble, the beautiful little orange treasure chest. Next to that is where I would like you to click.
Okay.
With the little almost Facebook icon.
Okay.
No, over.
This one?
No.
You over. Edit your...
Facebook icon. Yeah, there we go. Okay.
Okay.
All right. Champions, hit your champions.
Champions. There is going to be a little bit of delay, so just so you know. Okay. Okay.
I'm just going to sound needlessly frustrated for no reason.
Okay, so I'm here,
and we've got Ash. If we could scroll down, see who we've got working for us right here.
So Garen, Jinx, Kha'Zix, Lissandra, Lux, Ryze, Shyvana.
Oh yeah, you could have hit available and just known.
Oh, well, that would make sense.
A lot of fun to me. I love Jinx. Lux is a good beginner champion if you want to try out more of that support DPS role, like how I was playing.
Mm-hmm.
Varus is another one of those DPS attack damage champions. Usually, if you play Varus, you're kind of a dick, though.
Is he a ganker or?
No. Just usually the people who play him are kind of assholes.
Oh, okay. It's just one of those things. All right.
Yeah.
All right. Understood. Let's see.
Ryze is another one of those usually good for beginners. Garen is a good melee DPS for beginners, if that's more your style.
I'm okay with going ahead and sticking to range for now.
Okay. So Jinx is a lot of fun. I could walk you through some builds on her. Okay. And then still do support bot for you.
Oh my gosh, so 20s. She looks like my type of crazy. She looks like somebody like I would like totally be okay with playing all the times.
She is everybody's type of crazy. Like, I own her because she is so much fun.
I mean, the whole Chinese New Year dragon thing, I'm just like... And just the, you know, she looks like she's in mid-maniacal laugh. And I'm just kind of like, I like you.
She is pretty much always mid-maniacal laugh.
Well, there
you go. For example, one of her little flavor text moments is like, what does she say? I want to break something, like buildings or people.
Nice.
So, yeah, a lot of fun. Some of her mechanics are a little bit funky, though. So she's still going to build that AD like you were building on Ashe.
Mm.
But her Q, that first one, is going to switch you between two different modes for her auto attack.
Okay.
The first mode puts you on the minigun, which is going to be that rapid fire every time. And then if you hit that Q, it's going to switch you over to more of a grenade launcher.
Ooh.
Where it's going to just eat
AOE.
Your mana. But yeah, do splash and AOE damage like
nice.
No one's business. You'll really want to utilize that W. It's a skill shot, but it's a really good stun. So if somebody's running away from you, because you can't play Jinx and have people run away from you. It just doesn't
just no.
work that way. Just no. Yeah, that's the W. You're going to want to do that reasonably frequently. The flame chompers you're going to use as more of a disengage.
Okay.
So if somebody is putting it in your butt. You're going to toss those back behind you and keep yourself from getting sandpaper dildoed.
Okay.
And then, of course, Super Mega Death Rocket, one of my favorites.
You know, is probably very self-explanatory.
Super self-explanatory. You can pretty much hit somebody from the other side of the map, but it is a skill shot, so you'll need to kind of have an idea of where they are.
Okay. So it's something that you still need to actually aim.
Yeah, which is having that, see, when they're positioning it there, it's going to be doing it in the non-quick cast method. Using quick cast allows you to hit quicker, faster, more efficiently, unless you're that type of person that's usually playing your mouse really close to your champion. Don't do that.
Please don't.
Mainly because you need to know where your shit's going, you know?
Yeah. No, I don't. Yeah, that just sounds like a bad idea. Even if you're playing like a melee, it's just like, no.
Yeah, anytime that you can sort of plan ahead and move and like, hit the baseball. You want to hit through the ball.
Yeah.
So with League, you want to attack through the champion.
Sounds reasonable.
Mm-hmm. See, and they have that the flame choppers thing in such a way where it's like, oh yeah, and I place this, and they just run through it. No,
totally.
They can friggin' see it.
Yeah.
They don't. No, you have to place it as you're disengaging, or it's not gonna catch anybody. But Jinx is a lot of fun. Let's do that.
Okay. Get excited. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, can I do for we the notifications? No, I don't think.
What?
To do the quick cast thing, I don't think I could do it through this menu, can I? Menu.
Oh, no.
Okay. Of course not.
I don't think so. Wait, let me see. Okay, so if you hit your spells. Oh, yeah, what spells do you have?
Spells?
Have what, like Clarity, Ghost, and Heal right now?
Spells. Clarity, Garrison, Ghost, Heal, Mark.
Oh, Mark. That's interesting. Yeah, let's do Heal and Ghost like you've been doing. Remember to utilize those two. There's some champions that you end up using them way more. For example, I have all the way up from Clarity to Smite at this point.
Of course.
And I typically run Flash Ignite, because I usually play middle section champions. And there's the one that I play as sort of my main mid, Ahri. And her kit, you can get a kill without using your summoner spells, but using your summoner spells is a more guaranteed kill.
Gotcha.
And after a little bit, when you start kind of pulling in some other points, look at your masteries and sort of plan that out too, depending on what you want to do.
Nah. I kind of like, when I was like, what's this thing? What's this do? What's that do?
Yeah, you'll work your way through it.
Sure. I mean, is it a thing where eventually you can actually go ahead and fill everything out, or is it like, no, you can only really stick to one tree?
No. You'll want to know what's best for your champion. Like,
okay.
There's some things, like, you'll make multiple mastery pages.
Okay.
And be like,
oh,
okay, so this is my jungle AD, this is my mid AP, this is my support page.
Gotcha.
And it'll just be the best kind of cure-all that you can have for, depending on what myriad champions you have.
Okay. I was thinking more, you know, general RPG, you know, Western RPG, where it's like, you know, Fallout or or like do I wish to save? No. Yay, accept. Alright, so Jinx. And Queen Ducklings.
can't even type. And now comes the negotiations.
It's nearly 2 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, that's well, then. Fine. I guess you can be a dick. Okay. I'm trying to remember if that means that he's just not in the chat anymore, or if he's not playing. Usually it means he's not playing anymore, but that also still means you might not be able to...
Oh, because he chose Jinx. Oh,
yeah.
Shit. Well then, I don't
know. You can always go Garen. That's still that AD, but it's more of a...
My heart and
melee.
Sword.
Okay, we'll give it a try.
Alright, I guess I'm gonna... Oh, sounds... shit!
Oh.
I panicked.
My god, those are like World of Warcraft freaking pauldrons right there. That's serious business.
Oh, for Garen? Oh,
yeah.
He's something.
It's like, whoa,
so his
buddy.
Nickname is Spin to Win.
Ah, okay. He sounds almost kind of like a Sonya, because Sonya has a Spin to Win as well.
Yeah, you just swing your sword around and eat up people.
Sounds and very Sonya.
Oh, this is gonna be irritating. Because all I did was ask. I asked nicely. And I'm not gonna go down bot and support her, because, sorry.
It happens.
No, I'm trying to figure out the best way, because we don't technically have a support now. Like, Ahri can be played support, but that's not what she's for. So you and I are going to have to kind of work out with Jinx what's really going on here. Because Jinx can play a top, but somebody called top. We don't have a jungler, so we're going to have a dual top anyway. So maybe if we can convince Jinx to go top... instead of going bottom with us.
Or go.
Since it's going to be a dual lane, see if perhaps...
So many tails you have.
I have all the tails. All all 9 tails.
Such tails.
And they are on fire.
Oh, so I have to tell it every match to follow me on the mouse instead.
30 seconds until minions spawn. This is probably going to be my last game tonight, but...
Alright. Well, I mean, yeah, it's given me pretty much an idea. I think it's definitely helped that I've played, you know, HOTS and
all that fun nonsense.
Smite before. So they seem to have split up somewhat evenly, so...
Well, that's the problem, is they're not supposed to have. I mean, we could go down bot and be jerks and just take all of Jinx's last hits and force her up top. Because at this point, obviously, the person is refusing to communicate. And that's the problem with bot games. You don't get a lot of communication.
Alright.
So, I guess that's what we're gonna do.
Poor Demacia.
They gave us no choice.
Well, yeah. I don't like to be that teammate, but
yeah.
When there's zero communication. So I'm gonna be playing a little bit more aggressively based on my champion. Trying to do a little bit more of the last hitting, a little bit more poking, stuff like that. Because we're just going to play pretty much three carry spot and see how this goes.
Oh, I think she's gone.
I wouldn't count on it. She might just be placing
going
the
to camp or something.
She might. But you're right. It does look like she's giving it up. For the record, out of the two that we're playing against, that Miss Fortune is going to be a little bit squishier, but you want to focus that Taric more quickly. I'm going to still be mostly trying to give you last hits now that she's gone. But I'm gonna do what I'm gonna do is a lot of like focusing down for you, and then if you can try to just kind of keep an eye on where our enemy's life is and move in, you know, when you feel it's appropriate.
It's just that squishiness that I know I feel with Sonya the first couple of bit. And it's like I'm still getting the hang of his stuff, so it's just kind of like,
Alright. Okay, you'll get there. And like I said, you're gonna do almost a similar build as you had for Ash.
Okay.
Now, I am, like, running low on my mana.
Alright.
Because that's sort of one of the unfortunate aspects of the champion that I'm doing. Wonderful, wonderful champion.
Just a little mana hungry.
Yeah. Just eats it. Eats it like cake. Do you feel good about... I don't know. I'm gonna eat my last biscuit. And then, okay, so...
I made him angry.
For the record, if you hit the champion under their tower, the tower...
Oh, the tower automatically? Okay. I did not... That's something
I probably should have communicated to you.
No, yeah, I was like, yes. Huh. That escalated rather fast.
That out of hand real quick. So, and that's why they call it tower diving. When you're chasing a champion, you end up going under a tower.
Yeah.
Because you end up taking those hits whether you mean to or not.
Oh, no.
Stop it. I have no mana. I cannot help you. I pulled Miss Fortune off of you.
Alright.
The best I could do.
I should have grabbed some potions. I forgot about that.
So anytime that you're starting out with your champion,
yeah.
You want to allow for potions. You want to spend everything you have at the get-go.
An enemy has been slain.
Ari says playtime's over. Pretty much done with our enemy shit. Just, you know, over it.
Like,
I do love the connotation of Ari, though. She is the nine-tailed fox.
Yeah.
Super adorable, but, like, hard
for ferocious.
Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna stay under tower for a minute. Yep. You can just spin that.
spin
it up.
Wheel.
If you're not comfortable, like pushing out further, stay under cover.
Okay.
And you'll be fine.
Keep in yourself.
And like I said, with that Doran's blade, because you are building, so I can look, you've got Doran's shield. Once you move past those potions, and you're going to want to use them liberally because they're not going to be important come mid-game. Like, they're just not going to be anything important. Make sure you start building more of those AD items. Like, you don't want so many potions. Usually 3 or 4 is about the standard. You could probably get him. Oh, I want you!
Nah.
Nah. Not today.
It's okay, bruh.
I want to eat somebody, though. Which, I mean, I guess is more of a league term, because when you get a lot of kills, they call it being fed. I am not so familiar that I know whether or not that's something that other people... Oh, don't...
Yep.
Yeah.
I was trying to get the minions, not the person.
Which is why you want to look.
Yeah.
You want to check that out. Oh no. Alright, and run away.
Yeah, I was just like, no, I'm the closer target. Come on now.
No, take me!
I've got huge shoulder pads. Look at them.
I know what I'm doing.
She said as she just ran in and did things. Oh.
I just can't even with misfortune. She's such a slut. You try to tell her piracy's not the way to go. She doesn't care. Yeah, get out of the bombardier thing going on there. No, yes!
Nope, you don't see
me.
That
was a good little pincer moment, but I don't know how much you had available, and I am definitely running low on my mana. But what we can do based on our skills right now as champions is I'm definitely going to be more effective kind of pulling them in, because I have charm, which... is literally a taunt.
Aggro. Okay, yeah.
Like, it slows them, stuns them, and starts them moving toward your location.
Nice.
So it's good for, like, pulling people out from under towers if you want them badly and they just don't want to give it to you. Aw, oh, you prudish. We can just have this, I think. Will you let us have this misfortune? Come on! This is just, oh.
Why you gotta be like that?
Why you gotta be like
see if we can... Nope, they're both.
Yeah,
like, nope.
No,
oh no!
It hurt my heart. I'm gonna sell that door and play back. Fuck that. You get some boots too. Just up that mobility, you know?
Yeah.
Shut down.
So what have you got? Don't buy any more potions.
Okay.
Don't do it. Don't. Depending on your next back and when you get it, see about getting a more effective item.
Okay.
I have a feeling that the best thing for us right now would be if you build a tanky. So you'll want to build, what are they doing? They're building primarily, looks like AP right now. So you'll want to get, like, magic resist, you'll want to get health regen.
Okay.
All that good stuff.
Her trailing hearts.
See?
Yeah.
Oh, and I still got the kill. Oops. Sorry.
That's fine. Again, I understand. It's like, oh no, I care if we get the tower. That's my thing.
You are gonna be. Should you end up pulling more towards the ADC role, you're gonna be a wonderful ADC because none of your supports will hate you. And supports do this thing where if they decide they don't like you anymore, they stop supporting you.
And that's probably just not a grand thing to do. Oh, okay.
Well,
okay,
no, you're angry. It makes the game a lot harder for everybody. But I mean, I've done that with my supports too, where I'm like, look, my ADC is just being a dick, and as much as I try to be helpful, I'm done.
Try something. Four minions, anyways. Retreat! Run away! Bang those coconuts!
Oh, that was the best thing. My parents at one point, while I was living with them, and I was working, like right down the road, and. My dad had decided he wanted to do something with coconuts that weekend. So he got this coconut, and then he cut it in half, and they went... I was perfectly capable of dragging myself home from work. But they chose to come and see me as my shift was ending, request for me to come outside, and then as my brother banged the coconuts together, my dad galloped up to me and asked me how my day was.
Awesome.
Okay, run away. I try to be
like
helpful.
When it goes red.
When it really, when it's targeting your last minion,
yeah.
You start moving away. Because you're the next minion to the turret.
Pretty much.
Look at us.
Yay.
Aggression. I would not normally expect this composition to work for Bod. No way.
Go in, guys. Go in. I'm not using you. I'm not using and abusing you.
If we built a giant badger, perhaps getting into their base would be that much easier. Oh, don't spin on her!
Oh,
no, no!
Get away.
Nah. I
oh,
tried.
I wanted it!
We both tried. It was like, oh, come on!
And that's really the downfall of so many people on League, is that... I just want the kill!
Just the one! Just the one! Why can't you give it to me?
No, why?
It's like, why aren't I range right now? Curse yourself when you're not.
And then every time you're playing range, it's like, I wish I could just get a little bit closer.
I wish I was just, like, not as squishy.
No.
It's always like that.
In the fray right now.
Just want to mix it up.
You know how if you have naturally straight hair, you always want curly hair, and if you have curly hair, you always want to straighten it.
And you always want ginger hair, no matter what.
You do! For every incarnation you can have.
Poor Matt Smith. Still not a ginger.
Still not. And then though, to have new doctors be like, oh yeah, not a ginger, and I'm old and unattractive.
And almost a girl. Oh boy, they were like, we've had enough of you.
you're
like, done. No, you're starting to feel competent now. We can't have that.
We cannot allow this to continue.
No, you're getting comfortable.
Tarek, why? Get away from me. My ass is not for you. I don't like it.
No.
Help!
Exit only.
This world needs. I'll still come up and drop it right there.
So we have Phage and Bam, Bammy Cinder, Sunfire Cape.
Sunfire Cape is good. Okay. I really like Sunfire Cape because it has a an attached AoE.
Ooh. Oh yeah, Immolate. Oh yeah.
Yeah, super fun.
Get it on.
You just take that.
Get it on to the break it on. And then later on we play some Donkey Kong.
Starting to be a little bit dated.
looks like I don't know what's going on. Cruz is heading towards bottom again, so mid? Has destroyed a turret. Maybe? I don't know.
I'm going mid just for the sake of critter control.
Yeah.
There's just too many, and I just can't. And now there's two people in my way. And now you're in my way. Run away. Mostly run away.
Yeah, I know. Just get a little spin in and then bye!
Spin and ditch.
And it's dead,
Jim. I mean,
gem.
I'll take that, I guess. I mean, I guess bot was who fed them, so it would be best if we were the ones who took him. See, I feel like I've studied the champions that I like so much at this point that I don't even think about whether I'm QWE or R-ing. I just know, like, okay, this is my ulti, this is how I use this, this is what I'm doing.
Nope.
An enemy has been slain. And I think it's... part of it is just that ease of... it's like muscle memory, almost.
Nah.
And I love that about League. Because there's a certain amount of... You need to do a little bit of studying to really be good at what you're playing.
As everybody's like, we're just going to go off to the right because it's nice and clear over here right now.
Look at this! This is
open! Look! Hey! There's not as many people trying to, like, murderate us here. This sounds like a good idea.
This is called backdooring. Technically, what we're doing right now is split pushing, because we've got... Oh god, no, why?
Oh lord. I think they've discovered our ruse.
They did, and they were not pleased.
Nope.
Not pleased. So what are we looking at for you? Yeah, your build is not what I had hoped at this point.
Yeah,
like, for example, I just sold my, Doran's Ring, which is sort of like the beginner equivalent for my type of champion as the Doran's Shield or the Doran's Blade. And you've still got your shield, you've still got potions. Your potions are gonna really not do anything at this point, because by the time you think to hit them,
you're
dead. But you should have... I think by now, like level 10, 11, you should be upgrading your boots. You should have one completed item.
Okay.
I hope I'm doing okay. Like, I'm realizing I teach and everything, but am I really just teaching?
Well, it's hard when you're trying to do it on the fly and, you know, there's other things involved and it's just kind of like,
right. And I'm not even, like, in my music right now.
Oh, no.
to come down there and help you let my minion wave figure itself out. Those. Let's get that tower focus down. Just this one, not these.
Yeah, I'm like, where can I stand?
You can't be overlapping. It's like a really small Venn diagram.
Yeah.
So I had a ditch. Unfortunately.
Okay.
You can see, like, I'm down here, pretty much dead. But now we have super minions, and I'm reasonably confident I can rebuild my health as we go. Unless that happens, and I get killed.
I'm just gonna pick away at this thing from over here.
Nom 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 nom.
No, that's cool. Keep on fighting up there. It's no worries, man.
Yeah,
it's no worries.
No,
there you go, see? See? Now everybody can go home. Everybody can relax. Some people will be a little bit more happier than others, but you know, it's all part
special,
of the thing.
I am the only one up here almost dead.
Yeah.
So we did alright. I don't want to even deal with that jinx, though. I'm so mad about that. It's those moments where I just, why you gotta be a dick?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's gonna happen. It's video gaming. That's just how video gaming goes, so.
Right. But I still have that, like, that teacher mentality, right? Where I spend all day talking to kids about, like, respecting your peers. And then I get on League and I see that kind of behavior, and there's that part of me that wants to, like, PM them and just be like, why would you do that? Don't you have any respect for your peers? It's We're like, trying to build a team.
It's like, not everybody's pro yet, man. Not everybody's pro yet.
Just
oh my god, I went up a level. Woohoo!
Oh, I got honored. Which does feel good. When you get that message at the end, you've been like, it'll say, congratulations, your fellow summoners have honored you for your recent exemplary behavior.
Yeah.
And I had two of our teammates honor me for being helpful and having teamwork. The only one that I don't like getting is being friendly. Cause it's like, you sucked really hard, but you were cool about it.
I so see. I was wondering about that. I was like, friendly. How?
It's like the pity honor.
I gotcha.
When you just don't want to commit to really honoring somebody.
I see how it is. Okay.
But you know they worked really hard, so you want to reward them for their effort.
Yeah, you did good, kid. You did good.
I can see that you tried.
It's all right, man. Not everybody can have that day.
And then there's the pros where, like I've said, Kyle and I have been trying to keep track of LCS, which is like the global esports thing for League. We're all excited because we're gonna go see the spring finals. It's coming up in Las Vegas in April. Oh, got our tickets.
Yay! I don't know why.
So we've been keeping up on that, and it's really enlightening to watch how the pros play. For example, the other night we're watching a game and we're watching as they're building their team comp, and the casters are talking about how, oh, well, you know, usually you see this kind of comp from this team, but I think the last summoner decided that because they had such a heavy, like, AD team, that they would go AP instead, sort of balance it out with something. Because if you build, like, say if you're building a team, you know who you're playing with. And most of your teammates prefer an ability power, so more like a magic user situation. And you're comfortable building AD instead, doing that more like physical damage. Then typically you're going to end up picking AD because you want to balance out. Otherwise that team can just all build magic resist and defend against every single one of your teammates.
See, that's, I think that's something that was occurring a lot in Smite, like a lot of the time. So, yeah. I think that's why they tried to make some changes, but now it's just kind of like, too much. I don't know. Crumble would know a lot more about it than I would, because she actually, you know, she's really into it, and she's like, you know, yeah, watching all the videos, and, you know, she likes watching, like, the top players. Her thing is, it's like, I love watching the top players, but I always hope that I'm not the person that's getting, like, spanked by them, because I don't want that infamy.
Yeah.
So it's just like, I can understand that.
The thing about League, you have more of a clearer ranking system. Mm-hmm. For example, like, you're level 1, I'm level 26. So we probably had some people in our games anywhere in between.
Yeah.
Because it just throws off the data tree, you know?
Yeah.
But usually if I'm playing, like, just me, then I'm going to be in games with, like, anywhere between 25 and 29. And I'm not going to be playing against people who are typically pro, because I'm not playing ranked games.
Gotcha.
So there's no chance of being thrown into that, oh my gosh, I'm playing somebody from Team Solo Mid, is they're playing, like, their Nerf account.
And I'm just going to go cry in this corner.
Right. I'm just, that doesn't happen. It'll feel like that happens a lot of times starting out, but it doesn't really. It's just a matter of getting better. I think it's just, I've found so much more, it's been so much more rewarding with League because of the effort that I do put into it.
Mm.
And it's still pretty much pick up, put down as you please. Like, I can jump in and be like, okay, well, I want to try this new champion. This is the build guide I'm going to use. And I can just alt-tab the entire game and use my build guide as my little cheat sheet. And still build a reasonably effective champion.
Oops. Sorry, I'm trying to iron out, like, this is the first, one of the first times I've really tried, like, streaming from my computer, so it's just kind of, like, trying to figure out, like, the sense of all the things. Because it's really weird, because, yeah, like I said, it counts, like, the PvP net thing as one thing, and then the game as another, and it's just kind of like, how do I bounce between that? It's a little hard.
It's really obnoxious.
So, like, yeah, like, the entire time we've been talking, I'm like, no, I need something to be on the screen so it doesn't just look like black screen. And it's
black,
like,
screen conversation. No, yeah, it goes from PvP Net, which is, like, the website.
The launcher or whatever.
Itself, and then jumps into the client for the game.
Yeah. I think it just worked better when I just said, okay, this isn't, because it's like, If you ever start streaming or something like that, it's like, it'll say, like, game capture or window capture or, you know, such and such thing. And I was like, okay, well, I'll just put game and then see if it works. It's like, okay, it's working for that time. Now it's not working. Oh, gosh.
And then suddenly, no.
And suddenly, you thought you were being smart, foolish human.
You were so sure you had this figured out. Ah!
You're so cute. It's like, yeah, thanks.
Just negotiating with the computer through your keyboard. Just, why do you treat me this way? Like, I work so hard with you.
Totally. Do I not show you enough love? Is it because I watch Netflix most of the time on you? I'm sorry.
Yeah, I feel like computers get really pissed off about that, like, disproportionately.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's a lovely computer. My friend, or my roommate, rather, Slate, he built it for me, and, like, I've really been trying to, like, yeah, actually get off my butt and actually do, like, streaming and, you know, recording and all these things like that. But for a while there, yeah, it was mainly just Netflix and movies and other such things. But, you know, I was playing Fallout 4 for a long time, and then I was like, I need a little break from the largeness of this world. Although, yeah, I should really get back to it at some point.
Honestly, Fallout 4 has been one of those things where I really enjoy it because, like, as you can tell based on some of my game preferences, I like that I can sort of do as I please, or if I'm following a particular storyline, there's very clear goals.
Yeah.
And there is a certain strategy to Fallout that I enjoy. And it's almost like just more aggressive Sims.
Kinda.
Like,
yeah.
You build your little society, you work through all the things you want to work through. And I find that soothing.
It is. But my problem is, like, it's like, I never really got into Sims, and the reason why is because I knew it would consume me.
Ah.
And, like, you know, it's like, I want to decorate all the things, you know, and it's just kind of like, I don't think this is a wise thing. So
my problem with Sims ended up being that, like, I would enjoy playing, but I would get a hold of the cheat codes and just massively overstock my characters with money.
And you know what? When it comes to things like that, it's like, enjoy the game the way that you want to enjoy it. It's kind of like, you know, how in Minecraft, it's like, okay, you could do it legit and actually mine all your things and, you know, smelt them and everything like that. Or you could just go in for the pure creativity for it and, you know, just say, I need this block to build this thing, and that's how people, like, recreate, you know, like, Rivendell or, you know,
right,
the freaking Hogwarts castle and things like that. And it's kind of like, you know, enjoy it however the way that you want to enjoy it. For me, I always try to play through a game at least once, and then after that, I'm like, okay, I've finished this up. I can now allow myself to just, you know, put on all the god mode things and just run over people, you know.
Yeah, I remember doing that I was pregnant and I wasn't working, and my buddy was letting me use his computer because he had downloaded Sims, like, 3 for me. So not only was I playing Sims, but I pretty much went from, all right, so I'm playing Sims, this has been enjoyable, but they're pretty much living in a trailer park, and I'm really not down with that. That's not really what I was looking forward to. So,
like, this is reflecting real life too much.
I already live my life. I'm looking for a step up.
Right? Right? So it's just kind of like, I just need a little bit. I just need a little bit. That's all.
That turned into running, like, an entire vampire household with an income of 10 grand daily.
Yeah.
But it was fun.
And that's the important thing. It's a game, and you need to have fun with it.
Right. Sims does have that tendency to get repetitive, though.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because it's get a job, do something with your life. No.
Whereas at least in Fallout, it's just like, okay, I am tired of building right now. I need to go shoot something. And it's like, and you could go out and do that.
Right. Which is great, because I've been, like, tandem questing and scavenging and sort of trying to put together, like, I got so mad when I realized that they were going to take over Commonwealth, these little militia guys.
Oh, yeah.
Like, oh, I've built so much here.
Yeah.
And they're like, no, we're just going to have this, and you're going to help us take it, because we don't care about your needs.
Yeah.
And it hurt my feelings, and now I don't want to talk to Garby anymore.
I've had enough of you, sir.
So I've been, like, scavenging, just taking down raider places for a while. Just, and every single, stag and doe, red stags and what, I don't even know. Some of the terminology for Fallout, though, still gets me. Because I'm that person that I'll go to Starbucks, and I will purposely avoid using the terms like venti and grande.
Oh, yeah.
Because I just feel like a fool saying it out loud. So I'll be like, yeah, and can I have the caramel ice whip one with, I want the middle size. And they look at me like, can you not fucking read?
I will not fall for your induction or something.
Like, I'm not gonna go to, what's it, friggin' IHOP and order based on the kids' menu names for the items. I'm gonna order fucking pancakes.
I just want coffee.
Apparently they have this, like, clover machine that makes just super fancy coffee. And I'm sitting at home with my Keurig that I finally bought for myself. Like, oh, Keurig, oh, I can just make one cup at a time because that's all I drink in a day.
See, like, I was originally going to do that, but Slate, he's like, no, we're not getting a Keurig machine. I was like, okay, fine. And so he has to have, like, the little espresso thing with, like, the little handle and you put the coffee in and then blah, blah, blah. And I'm just kind of like, I'm pretty sure those machines usually, like, if you want, like, a good one, those are way out
of... hundreds of dollars.
Yeah, the price range that I really want to spend. So what I ended up doing was getting, what do they call it? The Aero... It's kind of like a French press, but it is kind of like single cup, and I've been pretty happy with that. So, I don't know.
See, when I did get the Keurig, I was not into the buying all the fucking cups for it, because that sort of negated the purpose of me getting the Keurig. I'm the only one in my house that drinks coffee, so why would I do a whole pot of coffee every single time I want coffee? Like, you know. And it takes forever. Duh, no. Nobody has time for that. So, we got the Keurig. But then I also got, like, the little refillable filter cup.
Yes, that is always... when I was living with my other friends, Mason and Mitchie, there were, like, you know, at least three of us living in the house at a time. So it's like, okay, it makes sense to, you know, have somewhat of a bigger machine. And it's just like, but we want to get our own coffee. Because, like, you know, like, my family would go to, like, Hawaii and we're like, we got you awesome Kona coffee. I'm like, yay. So, you know, it's just like, I could have Kona coffee from Hawaii or I could have whatever's in this little curry cup. Yeah. Now, yeah, we're gonna have to do the homebrew. Thanks. Okay, bye.
We're gonna skip your cheap American shit.
It's good when, you know, I just need a quick fix, but if I can get something a little bit better, I'm gonna do that.
Well, yeah. And, I mean, I still have my preference, even if it is Folgers.
Yeah.
It's the best part of waking up.
Is Folgers in your cup?
That's the thing.
There you go.
All right. Well, I have been holding my pee for quite some time now.
All right. Please take care of that. Please don't give yourself a UTI. Gaming is fun, but it's not worth it.
Well, okay. You cannot imagine how long I've ended up holding it just through my line of work.
True.
Like, those little a-holes get bathroom passes. I get to just sit there and write bathroom passes. So, I'm going to put it down for tonight.
All right. Thank you very much for walking me through. Hopefully there will be more of it, and I will be a little bit more... I will start getting more land legs and less sea legs about it.
Well, really, like, as you go through the champions, the free rotation changes again on Tuesday, so don't get too attached to these ones.
Yeah.
But go through and sort of pick out some that you would think you would enjoy playing, like conceptually look good to you. I'll help you find a build, kind of momentarily memorize it for you, walk you through it in game. And you can see more of playing based on what you want to play and not so much just what is effective for that moment. Because I can play off of pretty much anything. Like, if you want to play top, I'll play jungle. If you want to play mid, I'll play jungle. if you want to play jungle, I'll play mid or top. If you want to play support, I'll play bottom ADC. Like, I have something for everything.
All right. Okay. I think I just kind of need to go through, see what everybody's abilities are, you know, see what, you know, is either something that's familiar or something that looks like it would be fun to kind of give a whirl and then go from there and then see if it's something that I have to pay for. And then, yeah.
Well, so, like I said, just playing ends up building you that influence points.
That's true.
And there's, like, when you go to the store, it gives you a concept of, like, you can do it based on influence. Sometimes they have sales on certain champions. Obviously, the newer ones are going to be that, like, 6,300 RP or IP.
Mm-hmm.
But older ones, like Garen, I think, is, like, 480, which you can earn a quarter of in a game.
Hmm. All right.
So... All right. Apparently, my man friend also would like to play a game before we pass out, so I'm gonna.
He's like, just standing there watching you. It's like, I need to play.
Yeah, he had to excuse himself from the room because every time I would tell you something about League, he'd be like, "Are you sure? Are you sure, babe? Is that really what you want to tell her?" I'd be like, "Yeah, I know it too. Thanks."
It's like, that's you're being cute, honey. But you can go now. You can go. Bye bye.
This is, like, my one thing. It's the one gaming thing that I can mostly do better than he does. And I want to hold on to that. I just want to focus.
All right. Well, I'm going to stop the stream here. Thanks for watching. At least I know Jeff was watching, if anybody else was watching. Sorry that it was probably painful to watch me play, but I'm learning. Good night or good morning, wherever you are.